You might know it by now, React Native still exists because of its open source community. Beyond these repositories, releases, and nicknames, there are people. And you know what? I think it's about time to get to know who's been working for years on the great project we all love. So today, I want to introduce you to one of them. This is Thibault Malbranche, also known as Titozzz on the internet. And it's almost certain that you have used his work already.
So, hello everyone, I'm Thibault. I'm working in a company and also doing open source at the same time. I am currently the maintainer of some React Native projects that you might know, such as the WebView and other stuff. When I first heard of open source, it was like, it's Linux, it's only like 0.1% of people around the planet that really do this stuff, and it's probably not for me, and no one is going to work for free. But then I learned it's about like many other things, and it's not that small, and it's helping and it's maintaining tons and thousands of apps and products, and so many companies would be gone if open source software was not here. It's very interesting because it's kind of shifted what I thought, you know, like at first I was like, no one is using it and it's probably like not so big. And then you understand that everyone is using it and people doing open source are like in charge of so much power and like so many things.
To be honest, I felt the same way a long time ago. I was a hardcore user of many open source libraries, but didn't think this was also something I could do.
How I got re-engaged with React Native community was because I just love tinkering and updating and like being on the latest stuff. And so there was this update, I don't remember the number, but maybe like 54 or 53. And so it just got out, I update, I have a bug, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna fix it. So other people don't get the same bug. And so I track the bug down, I try to understand, I don't understand it, I find a hacky workaround, and I'm like, it works, but I'm sure we should not do this. And so I go on GitHub, and I create the issue, write down everything that I've searched, everything that I think, and I know it's not everything because I don't know the project well enough. But people saw that I was willing to try and willing to spend time and willing to help. Some people at this time answered and told me like, yeah, that's really cool, and it's okay to fix it like this, and we can do that. And thanks for taking time to do this and searching for the issue, and do you want to help more? And I was like, yeah, I want to do more things. And this is how it started.
This is very interesting because some people might think it's hard to get started when in the end, this could all begin with you fixing a bug and then being offered to help more on a project.
What's great about open source is the fact that you're part of a community. You start noticing the same names around and around on many like repository. You start, you know, at first I was like, oh, these guys must be so great. I see their name everywhere, they're doing everything. And then you start talking to them and you understand that these guys are like you, and you just like grow inside this community. And then you go to a conference and you see them in real life and you're like, oh, so cool, so that's how you look and that's who you are. And as long as you show that you're motivated and that you're willing to do stuff, any of these people that I've met are willing to spend time and talk with you. And that's great, because at first I never imagined I would meet this guy and talk with these guys as I do now. It's not a small step, but it's way easier than what you think. You just have to do it and get engaged and do stuff and talk. And I'm now that I know that, I'm always trying to look at, when I see someone that's motivated, that want to help, I'm always like, hey, do you want to do more? And you always need this fresh batch of people that are like the new generation, you know, of people interested. And there's tons of new developers now doing React Native and doing other stuff. I've been feeling very lucky when I started like being able to talk to everyone and exchanging with people and learning tons of cool stuff. And I want other people to like feel the same way, you know?
The essence of open source is to share your work with others. And if it's successful, this means a lot of people will benefit from your work.
it's kind of hard to know how many people use what I do. Just from like all the number of installs and everything, you can't really know. But I know that it's many people because, I mean, every place that uses React Native and that uses a web view, and that's, I would say, a big percentage of the apps, I've had so many people come to me and be like, oh, so you're doing this, and we're using it too, and we're using it too, and some other people are using something else. But I mean, now that I've made contributions to React Native or React directly, I mean, anyone that uses this technology, I mean, even if it's a small thing, they're using something you did, so it's fine. Doing open source pays back. All the time you spend helping people, that's time that I know other people are gonna be willing to spend to help me. If there's a bug and I can solve it, I fix it for everyone. And if I can't solve it, someone else is gonna help me. So I never get stuck anymore.
So at this point, you might be thinking, open source seems great, but how do you know if you should start doing it?
I feel like open source is something you should only do if you think it's interesting and if you want to be part of a community, if you want to help other people. You don't have to do open source, it's not a requirement, but I feel like you should at least understand open source and understand that it's people behind it. Always try to know why you're doing things, you know? I just created a pull request or something to help, and then someone offered me to help more, and I said yes because I like helping, not because I had some big plan or something. And it kept going like that, and it kept going bigger and bigger, and then you get asked to do like things on big repository, and it's really cool, and I like the feeling that I'm helping people when I can. Give yourself your own like motivation and your own reason to do it, and you'll have a great time.
All right, I hope this was interesting, and for those of you who don't know where to start, repositories you love are filled with lots of issues waiting to be fixed. Thanks again to Thibault, who made time for this. He's a nice guy, and you can find him on GitHub, Twitter, and recently Twitch. Remember to subscribe if you want more React Native videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.